And today I have something very cool for you. Today I have five ideas to raise funds for your food business. You must type yes in the... Hi, this is Gopal Kamath. I'm a restaurateur and a hotelier and the founder of Restaurant Launch Formula, where we teach you how to build, start and open a successful restaurant business of your own, a successful food business, any kind of business it might be. It might be a small QSR, it might be a big lounge, it might be a highway restaurant, it might be a cloud kitchen, any kind of restaurant. It is possible by using the step-by-step techniques we teach in the Restaurant Launch Formula. And today I have something very cool for you. Today I have five ideas to raise funds for your food business. You must type yes in the description section if you agree that funding is one of the most important issues when you go to start a restaurant. So let me give you a straightforward answer to this. If you are in a position where you are struggling with your day-to-day finances, you are struggling with your day-to-day expenses, you don't have your own money which you have kept to start a restaurant, you are just struggling with it, your income, your expenditure are going up and down. If that is the case, bluntly and without hurting you, I would like to tell you that you are not ready for this business as of now. First, take care of your existing situation, save some money, and once you get a chunk of money, then take that chunk of money, invest, take some borrowings and open a restaurant. If you're struggling here, don't go. If you're struggling at one place, imagine that you have put both of your legs in different boats and you are floating on the water. You will not be able to maintain the balance and eventually you will fall in the water. The same way, once you take care of your existing financial situation, only after that your mind will be steady and you can then focus on your new food business. So with that said, let's start with the first way of raising finance. It is a no-brainer, the one which I just told you. It is all about your own funds. If you have accumulated the funds, if you are borrowing it from your father, your mother, your relatives, it is more or less like you are getting it from your inner circle. And that is what I mean by getting the own funds. The second one is all about borrowed funds. You can borrow it from financial institutions. You can borrow it from cooperative banks. You can borrow it from any privately. I would not suggest you to borrow from privately. And I would not ever suggest you to borrow from money lenders because their interest rate is so high that it will literally kill you or it will literally not make it feasible for you to run a business. So always go for a financial institution. But moreover important, what I would like to tell you is you have to make sure that you have at least 15 to 20% of the whole project cost in hand with yourself, which is aside from your day-to-day expenses and day-to-day income, so that you can then pump in that money, take the other things from the financial institutions and then open and run a restaurant of your own. The third is collateral free. We have a lot of collateral free schemes in the market. Government is especially specialized into offering collateral free loans to small and medium enterprises, to small and medium businesses in order to help them to make some, help them to grow the economy. You can take advantage of that. You can sign up with them. You can go for a collateral free loan and you can then open a business of your own. Then comes the investors. The fourth one is the investors. You can get an investor who has a chunk of money in your business and then you could be the operational partner. You could handle all the day-to-day operations of the restaurant and then you can partner with that investor so that he just gets his shares of the profits as a return on his investment. And that will make sure that you have a strong investor in your business to take care of your finance. And the fifth is that you can literally partner with it. Of course, partnering and investors are some of the other times the same, but usually partnering is when you and the partner both put equal amounts together so that you are equally sharing the equity amongst each other and you guys are together running the show and you are sharing the profits. So these are the five ways of raising funds for your food business. I hope you love this. I hope you like this.
I hope you guys love the video and I'm sure this video and the information is going to help you to open a successful restaurant of your own. Now, if you want to go more deeper and have an in-depth understanding about the restaurant business, I suggest you join my 5 days WhatsApp class. The link is in the description section under this video. And in this 5 days WhatsApp class, I take you step by step to the foundational pillars of restaurant business and the food business. What should be your concept? What should be your location? What should be your thinking like a restaurateur's like our restaurant owner thinks? And how should you match it with the right type of target clientele? These are the core pillars on which the foundation of your successful restaurant holds. So if you really want to take it to a deeper level and have a better understanding about the restaurant business, go to the link in the description section and sign up for my 5-day WhatsApp class. There is a small fee which I charge so that you guys are serious and you can take it and implement it to open a successful restaurant of your own. So see you in the 5 days WhatsApp class. Thank you so much for seeing the video up till now. And see you in my next video. Thank you so much. This is Gopal Kamath signing off. Bye-bye. Love from me. Bye.